We got a lot of, you know, logistics to work out with a lot of phone calls to prospective guys and following up with a lot of information we've already gone through. So, we got a lot of work to do in the next while and hopefully get ready for Tuesday night.
You lost a great deal of Canadian talent, but I think you obviously still feel that you have in the upper half of Canadian talent in the league.
Well, I think we're in pretty good shape, but you never have enough. You know, you're an injury or two away from being really in trouble somewhat with depth. So, yeah, we've lost a couple, which means we have to reproduce that. So that's why the draft's so important.
What position are you going to focus on Tuesday?
There's a number of guys we're going to look at, and I don't think we have a specific position picked out that we're going to specifically follow, but there's a number of guys, you know, five or six that we'd really like to look at significantly, and if they're both there in both of our picks, that'd be great.
Does your board change because you've got to wait to see what happens with the NFL draft that doesn't wrap up until Saturday?
Not really with our board. I think it'll change some other teams, which then affects who's available for us, but I think the NFL draft always comes into play when it comes to this stuff, and some guys will fall just because of their availability.
Does it change a lot because their draft was ahead of yours?
Not really. I think it is what it is. I think you're still not going to know totally some pitchers of certain guys because our draft's Tuesday and they just finished theirs, I think, on Saturday night, Sunday kind of thing. So there'll still be a lot of things out there that are sort of in question.
How important is it for you guys to pick up special team ready type players with the Newman Butler departure?
Well, I think that's a factor. I think anytime you go into a draft, you want to be able to have guys that do more than one thing if you can. So special teams will obviously be one thing we want to look at. So that'll be an area that, you know, I know Coach Dice and Corey have talked over the last while about some skill sets that we're looking at. So that'll definitely be an issue we look at.
From your point of view, how much did Quinn Smith hurt himself yesterday?
You know, like any draft pick we go through with certain guys, we have criteria that we look at and we do extensive interviews. And, Terry's going to be going through that again, and he'll call him over the next few days just to see the specifics, a little bit more of what we've heard about it. But, you know, no different than anybody else, we'll add up the pluses and minuses and see where it falls.
Were there numbers at the...
No, I'm not going to say that.
Were there numbers at the combine compared to other testing previously that make you have to do even more work on Quinn Smith?
Yeah, well, I think with everybody, you know, anybody that we have in our top 10 to 15 picks, we do extensive conversations with, which we'll do over the next, you know, 3 days or so. And with him specifically, we'll go over that topic with him and just ask him what happened. But to say we're going to pick him right now amongst 30 other guys, we don't know if he's going to be one of any picks at all. But we'll do our homework on it and just see where it goes.
Brendan, how would you categorize this draft? Is it a deep one or not?
I think, you know, your first 10 to 15 picks are somewhat the same as usual drafts. I think where they fall off a little bit is when you get to the 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th rounds kind of thing. I don't know if it's as deep as usual.
Is that because of the rule change?
I think that's part of it, yeah. I think it is. Yeah, I think for sure it is. I think that's limited some of our guys that are eligible, so the depth as a whole might not be as good as it used to be.
You've had pretty good success in the late rounds, though, so it's kind of, you know, you've also had a lot of late round picks.
Yeah, you know, sometimes when you make those transactions, you have to weigh if those guys, quality guys, are going to be there at that point. So I don't know if we would do that this year specifically just because of the depth of the draft. So in certain years, you can get away with doing that and still be okay, but I'm not sure we can do that this year.
How valuable is this eighth round pick to you, eighth overall pick?
As I said, I didn't know there was eight rounds.
How
valuable is it to us? I think the great thing is we're picking eighth and ninth or whatever it is going to be, because if you're picking first and second, that doesn't mean you had a good year. But it's valuable. Every time you have a high pick, it's very valuable. So we've identified certain guys that we'd like to pick if they're there, and if they're not, then we'll see if we keep it.
So we keep hammering the special teams to lead. It's going to be a lot of top quality. Few top quality offensive linemen, and it will be linebackers and those type of guys. You think that might be the idea, to be supplemental guys that can sort of boost the roster when you pick?
I think anytime you pick anybody at the eighth pick, you want them hopefully to make your team. Whether they contribute right away, we'll see. You know, with Corey Wattman last year, he played X amount of plays, but he wasn't an impact guy. But I don't think anybody expects that right away. But hopefully they can come in and make your team. And if it's a special teams player, they can, you know, play a couple roles on teams and help your team out.
Are you happy with how last year's draft class turned out for you guys?
Yeah, I think as a whole we are. You know, it's funny you say that because we were thinking about that the other day and how many guys, like Murray said, in the fifth round ended up making our team. And yeah, I think as a whole we came out of it pretty good. You know, you don't really want to take too many guys that didn't make your team or didn't turn out very good. And we even had a guy like Matt Vaughn go back to school that's going to come back and be a pretty good player, we think.
Brendan, is sort of the goal to have two guys at least per draft make this football team?
No, I think it depends on the team that you have. If you have a really good team and you're deep in Canadians, it's hard to have one guy make it, let alone two. But, yeah, I think that's a safe and good, accurate comment, that if you can get a guy or two every year make your team and have somewhat of an impact on your team, that's a pretty good draft.
How many conversations have you had about trading this pick, maybe moving to next year, that may be a lot deeper draft?
Yeah, that's a good thought. And I think, you know, for the last 4 years, I think we've made a trade on draft day, as a matter of fact. But we've had some communications, whether we go up or down or stay, so... there might still be some activity on draft day still again, like we usually are doing. So, but it has to make sense, so we'll see where it goes.
Can you give us any kind of a hint what it's like inside the organization? Any other sports league in the world, these labor negotiations are front page news every day, but what's it like on the inside here, not knowing a training camp is going to start on time?
You know, honestly, we're so deeply involved with the draft and getting ready for training camp in 3 weeks. We have to operate that things... as much as they can be normal, they're normal. So obviously the CBA is a very touchy topic that I'm not going to touch on, but we are very deeply indebted in what our day-to-day routine is, so we really don't, we leave that up to the commissioner and the higher-ups to work it out, and we just operate as is and see where it goes.
Worry about it if it happens?
When they tell us we have to worry about it, we'll worry about it, but up until then we're operating business as usual.